trouble, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. There is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The heathen raged, the kingdoms were moved, and he uttered his voice, and the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the works of the Lord, what desolations he hath made in the earth. He makes the forest to cease to the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear asunder. He burneth the chariot into fire. Be still and know that I am the Lord. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. I was just thinking on this verse, what an encouragement it is. And what I see here in verse number one, there's just a real assurance. God giving a wonderful assurance to us. The psalmist said, God give us our refuge and strength and a very present help in trouble. You know, the phrase, God is enough. We don't need any more assurance than that. You know, whatever it is that we're facing, God's enough. And the phrase that God is ours. He's our refuge. But to know that He is our God and we are His people, well, that's an assuring verse. But the psalmist says that He is our refuge. He is a place to run to. He's our place of shelter. And then He's our strength. It is oftentimes that people say that, I want to be a strong Christian. I need to be strong in this situation. But the Apostle Paul says that it is when I am weak that I am strong. It reminds us of part of dependency upon the Lord. And we tend to not do that when we're not assured that God is ours. We tend to not do that when we're not assured that God's enough. But the Bible says that He's our refuge and our strength. And He's a very present help in trouble. Thank God for the help that the Lord is. Thank God for all the things that He does for us and gives to us. But the phrase, He's a very present help. He is here. It's immediate. I'm glad that God's not quarantined. I'm glad that He's not on life support. I'm glad that when we call on Him, His line's not busy. Here at the church, we've been having to fight the internet just to try to stream our services. And we can drop signals. I'm glad that God's never out of range and He never drops signals. He's a very present help. In trouble. And the verse tells us in verses 4 and 5, it talks to us about verses of supply. The Bible says there is a river, and the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God. God is in the midst of her, verse 5 says, and she shall not be moved. God shall help her in that right early. Boy, I see these verses, and I just think of the river of grace that God offers to us in our times of need. There are multiple types of grace. I believe there's saving grace. I believe that the Bible teaches that it's not by works or righteousness as we have done, but we're saved by faith through grace. And so, or by grace through faith. And so, God gives saving grace. And boy, just for anyone who's out there that may not know the Lord Jesus Christ, I want to tell you He loves you and He'll save you. And the Bible tells us of saving grace, but it also tells us of sustaining grace. And that, I believe, is the grace that Paul prayed for. When he saw the Lord Christ for the thorn in his flesh, and the Lord told him that my grace is sufficient for you. I just want to encourage Christians today that in troublesome times, in times of discouragement, and I know right now our focus is on the coronavirus, but it's the virus today. It'll be something else tomorrow. And it'll be something else the day after that. There will always be a need. There will always be something that will drive us to the Lord. But God has grace. And God told the apostle, Paul, He said, my grace is sufficient for thee. It is sufficient grace and it is sustaining grace to see us through whatever it is that we are facing. But I believe there is secure grace. The Bible here talks about that river that flows and God is in the midst of her. And He says, she shall not be moved. And God shall be her help. And you know, in times of trouble, the reason that believers are able to stand and not to have doubt is because God secures them. God has assured us that He is our refuge, and He is Frustrated and concerned over things that we may or may not happen. And God says, just
Amen.
All right, let's pray. Father, we're sure thankful tonight that, God, we can bow in your presence, and Lord, we can rise above all circumstances and situations. Lord, to come to the throne of your grace, Lord, that high place, Lord, that place of elevation. Lord, not that we are lifted up, but Lord, that we are carried into a sanctuary of grace, God, that you have created for us to come. And Lord, times like these, Lord, I know that people are uncertain and they're fearful and people don't know how to react. And Lord, the reality is that nobody has all the answers right now. Nobody could have been anticipating what this was going to turn into, what it was going to be. But God, I know it's going to have an effect. And what I do pray, Lord, is that we don't just use prayer in times like these. But God, we come. And Lord, out of the pleasure of our hearts, Lord, to you, because we know it is the pleasure of your heart. We can come in times of trouble, good or bad. Lord, I just pray that as we do that, Lord, help us to have the assurance in our heart that you are God. Lord, there's none other besides you, and there's nowhere else that we need to turn. But God, we can come to you. Lord, you're the Lord of hosts. You're the God of Jacob. And Lord, we can turn to you because, Lord, you are our God. Lord, I pray tonight, God, for any of those that maybe the sound of our voices. And God, may just be encouraged. Lord, tonight,